The Great Barrier of the Canadian Rockies has always been a challenge to the most intrepid adventurers in all its cold beauty and silence. But nowadays, the mountains echo to another kind of invasion. Skiers have discovered a great new winter playground. And the mists of early morning find many a group of enthusiasts organizing for the day's adventure. You don't even have to be an expert to join in the fun, but there are some useful tricks to know about mountain skiing. For the long climb ahead, climbing skins are attached. They are usually made from seal fur. The seal is a smooth fellow, but when you rub him up the wrong way, he's no backslider. All glamour is forgotten in favor of sensible protection for eyes and skin. The high altitude and dazzling snow make dark glasses imperative, and a thick coat of face cream prevents a painful sunburn. With the morning air so crisp and diamonds beckoning in the snow, everybody is impatient to finish the preparations and get going. But the mountains have their rules, too. The first one is, don't start out before you've checked every bit of equipment. And the next is, don't travel alone unless you know your mountains like a book. Inexperienced people don't always think of things like that. That's where the guide comes in. His years of training and a license to prove it are a big factor in the success of the party. His uncanny vigilance guards against unpleasant surprises like avalanches and precipices. But it's a free country. And of course, there are always those people who want to be alone. At last you're away. Away from city life. Away from noise. Above the crowds. Above ski toes. You're off to ski in the sky. Short of breath maybe now, but left, right, left, and you'll get your second wind. Regular, steady, and now the timber line is left behind. Higher and higher, and the world opens out into wide expanses of shimmering white. Hard work now, but what a prize is in sight. At last, you've made it. You're on top of the world. It only takes a moment to get your skis off and then crowd around for a chocolate bar. Then comes the real reward. One of Earth's majestic sights stretches as far as the eye can see. Somewhere down there is a tiny cabin. Towering in every direction are snowy giants of the Canadian Rockies. And below is another party of skiers. Well, would-be skiers. Only two. Where's their guide? It's those youngsters that didn't need one. Oh, well. Now for the rundown. Climbing skins come off and are quickly stowed away. Is everybody ready? Let's go! sold everything. There's trouble down there. Let's have the glasses. Those crazy kids. Can't they see that precipice over there? They're heading right for it. Hey! The only way to stop them is to get down there fast and first. There you are. That's what you just missed. Only 800 feet, that's all. And you're the ones who could take care of yourselves. All right. Now you come along and travel with the others. And be quick about it. Interruptions can happen in the best downhill runs. Soon there's a happy reunion, and thanks and congratulations all round. To the guide, it's all in the day's work and soon forgotten. It's soon forgotten by everybody in the thrill of the final run home. Blood tingling and a tired but happy feeling of accomplishment, the little cabin is a welcome sight. Is anybody hungry? With luck, it might be just about feeding time. Yippee!